guys, welcome back to the Wozanazo Transfer Show. On today's episode, we have Pirates drawing Lucky Boy Race, Sundowns closing on Highlands Duo, and a Kaizer Chiefs star could join Percy Tau in Belgium. Right before we get into the episode, please don't forget to smash that subscribe button and turn on all your notifications so you are always up to date with the latest PSL news. Our first story of the episode takes us to the mother city as Zanaco confirms Zulu move to Cape Town. Zambian Super League giants Zanaco have confirmed that a deal for a winger Charles Zulu is almost done and the player will sign for Cape Town City. City have snapped up one of the hottest Zambian prospect from Zanaco for an undisclosed fee, with the EPSA Premiership side set to announce the signing of the 24-year-old midfielder ahead of the 2021 season. Zulu is a pacey winger who mostly operates from the left and is set to give 32-year-old Surprise Rulani some competition for the starting berth in Cape Town. Our next story takes us back to Soweto as Orlando Pirates join Lucky Boy Race. Jack of all trades, Lucky Boy Mukwena has caught the eye of Orlando Pirates, who are believed to be considering a move for the Highlands Park defender slash midfielder as they look to overhaul their defense and strengthen their squad for the upcoming season. Orlando Pirates look to strengthen with football on the African continent imminent for the Buccaneers next season. Mukwena's versatility and consistency has made him a target for a number of PSL giants, with the likes of Mamelodi Sundowns and now Orlando Pirates joining the race for his signature. With the Lions of the North believed to be on the verge of being sold to Glad African Championship side TS Galaxy, players at the club are said to be plotting their potential exits. The 26-year-old has made appearances right across the entirety of the backline, from right back, center back to left back, chipping in with a goal and 5 assists in all competitions. So Lucky Boy does not only bring versatility, but is also a goal threat. Orlando Pirates will have to work overtime to bring him in, but he would be a welcome addition to the Buccaneers' defensive ranks. Guys, please let me know in the comments below if Lucky Boy can bring something to the Buccaneers. Staying with the Lions of the North, the Sundowns close in on Highlands Duo. Mamelodi Sundowns have made an approach to land two of the biggest Highlands star players at the end of the season. The Lions of the North are in the process of selling the club, which has cast doubt over all their players' future. Highlands are reportedly willing to sell their top players should they reach an agreement to sell their PSL status. Striker Peter Shalulile and midfielder Toby Mvala are two of the most valuable stars at the club. According to sources close to both players, Shalulile and Mvala's future will be decided this week. Sundowns are in the final stages of negotiations and an agreement could be struck by the end of this week. Highlands Park's chairman officially confirmed that there are official negotiations going on for these two players between the clubs. "I can't confirm or deny that we're in talks with teams regarding these two players. There has been ongoing negotiations, but nothing is concrete. But negotiations should be concluded by next week. With the league coming to an end in the next few days, we could see new developments in the Highlands Sundowns negotiations. Should Shalulile and Vala be the latest additions to the project at Clearcorp? Please let me know in the comments below." Kaizer Chiefs star set to join Percy Tau in Belgium. Dumisani Zuma has been linked with an exit from the Glamour Boys with a move to Belgium side St. Truiden. Reports from Belgium claim that St. Truiden have made an official mega offer to Kaizer Chiefs for their wideman. The offer is rumored to be around 1.5 million euros for the former Bloemfontein Academy product, which is said to be close to around 30 million rands. Zuma just signed a 4-year extension with Chiefs last season, so all the power lies with the Naturena-based outfit. Zuma has contributed 3 goals and 3 assists in the EPSA Premiership this season, mostly playing a super sub role for Kaizer Chiefs under German tactician Ernst Mettendorf. Kaizer Chiefs should cash in on such a lucrative offer for the 25-year-old, who's currently ruled out with a hamstring injury. If the Glamour Boys were to accept the offer, they could take the 30 million rands and reinvest it into their aging squad, reinforcing areas like midfield and defense with needed PSL quality. A perfect replacement for Zuma would be Bloemfontein and former Orlando Pirates wonderkid Menzi Masuku. Masuku at 27 seems to be finally living up to his early potential and coming off his best season so far in the PSL with 10 goal involvements this season. He would be third behind Samir Nekovic, Lebohang Manyama in terms of creativity in the Kaizer Chiefs squad. Masuku's numbers have outperformed the likes of Kamo Bilyat and Lazarus Kambole. 6 goals and 4 assists in the league show a player entering his prime and would come at a very significant low price, with the white man currently valued by Transfermarkt at 7 million rands. Bloemfontein could be persuaded to part ways with their prized asset with a bid of around 5 million. So Chiefs could sell Dumisani Zuma, getting a replacement and still a net 20 to 25 million rands. This is a no-brainer. Please let me know in the comments below if you think Dumisani Zuma can make it in Belgium or this is just a rumor from the rumor mill. Yep, guys, right before we end the episode, we have to address the penultimate end of the PSL. The PSL will be decided on the last day. Currently, Chiefs and Sundowns are equal on points at top of the log, but Chiefs have a slight advantage in terms of goal difference. Kaizer Chiefs getting a 1-0 win over Chippa United last night with a goal coming from Kamo Bilyat with the big Serbian flicking on to the far post and Bilyat just sliding in to give Kaizer Chiefs the lead against Chippa in the 80th minute. And Chippa has struggled really against Chiefs, but Chiefs could only score a single goal courtesy of Kamo Bilyat, his second goal of the campaign, with Chippa receiving 2 red cards. But Sundowns ran rampant, guys. Sundowns' performance against Polokwane City was immense, with 3 goal scorers on the night. But the highlight of the night was Themba Zwane's goal, gliding in between 3 players, just showing his quality, that Zwane can still contribute, that he still have it. An actual teammate of Kamo Bilyat, he's a former team in Mamelodi Sundowns, really trying to chase down Kaizer Chiefs, waiting for that mistake. But Zwane's goal was a thing of beauty, accelerating and putting it past Chigova and his defenders. But the league will be decided on the last day, as Sundowns will take on Black Leopards and Chiefs will take on Baroka. Guys, please let me know, who do you think will win the league? Is it Sundowns courtesy of a Chiefs mistake on the last day, or will Kaizer Chiefs hold on to win the league? Please let me know in the comments below, guys, and we can't wait for the penultimate end of the EPSA Premiership. It's been a long season and I can't wait to see who will rise on the final day. Please leave your predictions in the comments below and I'll see you guys in the next episode.